I'm playing the Vic Open next a week and a half. It's a pro tournament on the Australasia Tour, and then the week after I got the World Super Six at Lake Karinup, where we played last week, and I'm pretty excited for that. It's my first European Tour tournament, so yeah, I'm pretty pumped for that, and hopefully I go well.
And of course, you've got the USM
Yep,
coming up.
USAM. I'm probably going to play the same schedule as last year. I'm not sure if I'm going to go to the UK, but I'll play the US again, play all those tournaments, and yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Well, you play the Lytham Cup in
Lytham
Scotland?
Trophy.
Not sure.
No.
Yeah, I don't know. Depends what fits in my schedule. I obviously want to play. I think I'm going to go over for a month, which I did last year, and played four events, which was a bit too much. So. I know this year that I'll cut down a little bit and then be ready for the USAM, which is the big one.
And are you still eligible for the Junior Invitational at Sage Valley?
No, I think I had a look. I had a look at the website, and they said you got to be 18 at the beginning of the year. So I've already turned 19, so I can't
Okay.
play.
All right, Carl, what's your upcoming schedule?
Well, I have Jones Cup in 4 days, and then after that, it's kind of my off season. A lot more work in the gym and on school, but it's going to be pretty laid back for the whole month of February. I have nothing in February. March, I might have one tournament, and then April, everything starts to come back up with the Junior Rotational and maybe the Terracotta. And then once June comes around, it's nonstop traveling around the US. Might go to Europe this year. Hopefully, I get into the USAM. And then after that, everything kind of slows down again. So it's going to be the same as last year, pretty much, minus a couple tournaments, and then added a couple new ones in more international.
So it sounds like you're basically following what Minwoo just said, in that you have a run of tournaments that you know you're physically and mentally capable of doing, but then you ensure you have a good long break to go back to the basics, work on your skills, gym work, etc., before your next run of tournaments. So you're having a run now, you'll then have February and most of March off, you'll have probably two or three in April sort of period, then have a break until June, and then June it's just, as you say, non-stop for the summer.
Yeah, everything kicks off with the Thunderbird, which is the end of March. Sorry, May. And but yeah, I just played four tournaments in a row, and then Jones Cup is my fifth, and then I haven't really taken an off season in the last 2 years. It's just been nonstop tournaments, and I think it'll be good to kind of rest my body. I just missed a month of school, so I got to catch up on all that stuff. But it's good to take a break every now and then, since you're always grinding and practicing. So it'll be good for me.
Dog leg left. This all sets up perfectly for Carl. Yeah, he's nailed that.
Where you going, Frank?
Right up the high diddle diddle. Yep, a couple of good drives. Minwoo's right up next to Carl. So Minwoo, that thumb seems to be holding you back a bit.
No, not really. I'm actually driving it better than normal, so I think broken thumb's the way to go when you play golf. It's a new trend in 2018 that I'm starting, so.
Yeah, it's like whenever I'm sick, I win a tournament.
Yeah, exactly.
I had a swollen foot at Southern.
And you won.
85 yards up the hill. Probably playing 90. Good shot for me.
Right on the target. Yeah, up next to the pill, right next to Carl is Minwoo. Well, there'd only be a yard difference. You can see Minwoo's come in a lot shallower. He's stuck that close. So, Minwoo, you're regarded as one of the long hitters in the amateur game.
Yeah, Yeah, I normally title that, but I guess, yeah, I'm getting to a stage where driving distance doesn't really matter. There's a lot of players that hit it short and win tournaments, so I guess the accuracy comes into play now, I guess it's a big advantage, I guess, on the PJ Tour. All the people that win, or like the top ranked players, hit it the longest, or the top 10 longest average drive.
And so, did you have a driving competition with Jason Day last year?
Yeah, I did. I went to Junior Invitational at Sage Valley, which is a great tournament that I hope that all the juniors get to play that are watching. I had just a little competition with Jason Day when he was doing a clinic, the long drive comp. So that was fun, and I ended up beating him by I think 20 yards, 30 yards, which was pretty cool. I got to hit his drive and I roasted it. So it was just a good time to hit it good in front of everyone. So that was fun. I saw him at the Australian Open too, and he's a really good guy, really nice guy, and great player too. That was a good experience.
So Carl was at Sage Valley there. Is it true that when Jason asked for someone to challenge him, that Carl ducked out and hid?
Yeah, I saw him. I looked at him, then I don't know. He just disappeared. I didn't know where he was. I'm pretty sure some of the boys were told Carl to get up, but nowhere to sit. No, I didn't even see him.
chicken. Got to get back to better alignment and better putting stroke. It's better. He just hit the cover off it. Much better putting stroke. He hit it through the break there. Minimum to go three up. Oh. Ninwoo hit his through the break. Well, just overread it a bit. Some people say that that it's no big deal to be prepping for college, but one of your buddies, Fred Lee from Perth here, he actually gave a couple of big tournaments here a miss, so he could catch up with his studies. You're committed to Stanford, and I hear that you've got a pretty heavy academic workload. How does that interfere with your golf?
During the day, during the school days, it really doesn't interfere much, but then once I get to tournaments, it's hard to keep up with all the work. And doing online school, I take one class online, and then keeping in touch with your teachers, you know, it's hard, but you have to be prepared for it. And it's good preparation going into college, knowing what it's going to be like, because in college you're traveling to tournaments with a team, you're going to have to keep up with your work. They're not as lenient as high school teachers, so they're going to be a lot stricter, but it's definitely good prep, and it'll be a challenge, but I'm looking forward to it.
What about par three?
Pretty long.
Into the wind.
Oh no. Oh, straight, but it's short.
Get up. Straight challenge.
Minwoo's ball got hit by the breeze, and he's really nursing his thumb on his left hand. So he's got a good excuse for not being able to play his irons as aggressively as he normally would. He's just missed Carl there, so he loses points for not hitting Carl.
Door's open.
And
I'll go ahead.
Carl's just stopped dead where he hit. Don't know what the hurry is, Carl. Let him putt. Alright, Carl putting for his birdie. The hole needs to be a foot wider for Carl to be sinking any.
to go left.
That's alright.